Good morning, everybody, and welcome to our Sunday liturgy being led this morning by the Virginia Gospel Choir. I welcome you all who are watching in today. We ask God's blessing down on you as we celebrate this Mass for the Holy Souls, remembering very especially the deceased members of the Gospel Choir and all of their families, and all of those whose names are at our altar, those whose names are written in our hearts from love, those we have forgotten and those that are forgotten. Every word is to the praise of God. Every song is to the praise of God. Let us listen to our opening song this morning.
Reading, a reading from the Book of Wisdom. Wisdom is bright and does not grow dim. By those who love her, she is readily seen and found by those who look for her. Quick to anticipate those who desire her, she makes herself known to them. Watch for her early and you will have no trouble. You will find her sitting at your gates. Even to think about her is understanding fully grown. Be on the alert for her, and anxiety will quickly leave you. She herself walks about looking for those who are worthy of her, and graciously shows herself to them as they go, in every thought of theirs coming to meet them. This is the word of the Lord.
Second reading, a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We want you to be quite certain, brothers, about those who have died, to make sure that you do not grieve about them, like the other people who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and that it will be the same for those who have died in Jesus. God will bring them with him. We can tell you this from the Lord's own teaching, that any of us who are left alive until the Lord's coming will not have any advantage over those who have died. At the trumpet of God, the voice of the archangel will call out the command, and the Lord himself will come down from heaven. Those who have died in Christ will be the first to rise, and then those of us who are still alive will be taken up in the clouds together with them to meet the Lord in the air. So we shall stay with the Lord forever. With such thoughts as these, you should comfort one another. This is the word of the Lord.
Yeah.
prayer. O God, in whom mercy and forgiveness belong, hear our prayers on behalf of our relatives and friends who have gone before us, very especially those whose names are on our altars during this month of prayer for remembering. Because they put their trust in you, we commend them to your heavenly care, that they may come to enjoy your eternal reward. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and with the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever. Amen.
Lord, we pray for all of us here today that God will give us the grace to know his presence in our everyday lives. Give us the strength to make it through these difficult times and to know him as our companion in times of loneliness, our healer in times of suffering, and our guiding light and hope in our journey through life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, in November we recall and pray for our deceased loved ones. While we feel grief and loss, may we remember that they are safe in the loving arms of Jesus. As we think of the funerals we attended so differently this year, let us pray for the care and attention given by the frontline workers who work so hard to keep us all safe. Lord, hear us.
God, we pray for all who are currently grieving the loss of a loved one. We pray for strength and support in these difficult times to overcome the loneliness. We remember those dearest to us, especially our beloved friends and fellow choir members, Paddy Kellett and Thomas Riley. Lord, hear us.
Every day we need you, Lord, but today especially we need some extra strength to face whatever is to come. This day, more than any other day, we need to feel you near us, to strengthen our courage and to overcome our fear. By ourselves, we cannot meet the challenge of the hour. We are frail human creatures, and we need a higher power to sustain us in all that life may bring. And so, dear Lord, hold our trembling hands. Be with us, Lord, this day, and stretch out your powerful arm to help us as we place all our hope in you. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose days are without end and whose mercies beyond counting, keep us mindful that life is short and the hour of death is unknown. Let your Spirit guide our days on earth in the ways of holiness and of justice, that we may serve you in union with the whole Church, sure in faith, strong in hope, and perfect in love. And when our earthly journey is ended, lead us rejoicing and singing into your kingdom, where you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you all. May Almighty God bless all of you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our liturgy is over. Let us bless the Lord. Stay well, stay safe, and know it's going to be a lovely day.